this video, we'll show you how to wire the Fisher Easy Drive electric actuator. As always, make sure you take the appropriate safety precautions described in your instruction manual. First, we'll connect the wiring to the terminals within the Easy Drive actuator on this Fisher D4 globe valve. Here are some important wiring practices to follow. Make sure none of your wires are live during this procedure. Make sure you're qualified to do the wiring and observe all appropriate wiring practices for hazardous locations. 18 to 12 gauge wire size is required. For long wiring runs, we recommend using a lower gauge. For power, any wire over 50 feet should be 12 gauge due to the voltage drop. Fuse the system to 5 amps, 4 amps supply minimum at 12 or 24 volts DC. Ensure all signal shields are connected at the signal source only. Now, let's wire the positioning version of the Easy Drive electric actuator. Each terminal on the terminal cap has been clearly labeled. The power is polarity sensitive, so make sure the power cabling has been properly installed and grounded before attempting to power the actuator. Analog signal wiring should be installed across the terminals labeled 4 to 20 milliamp plus and 4 to 20 milliamp minus, connecting the positive and negative wires respectively. Shielded signal wire is preferred in all installations and, again, should be grounded at the signal source only. The actuator has an additional configurable digital input-output. For wiring as an input, connect a dry contact switch to terminals digital plus and digital minus. It's a 10 volt DC input. For wiring as an output, the output can source up to 25 milliamps at 10 volts DC. Attach RS-485 Modbus wires to Modbus terminals A and B. Apply power to the unit. A green LED light to the right of the terminals will blink when the power is on. You've now successfully wired your Easy Drive electric actuator. Contact your local sales representative or visit emerson.com to learn more.